Hello, this is a short screencast to demonstrate the new Platform.sh integration with Bitbucket. Platform.sh is a second generation platform as a service with some very unique features. Atlassian Bitbucket, with more than 3 million developers, is the premier private Git hosting for teams. Assuming you have a Bitbucket account, you can go to the brand new add-on directory, choose deployment from the categories drop-down, and click on install next to the Platform.sh add-on. Voila, it's almost done. You would have already committed to the Git repo a couple of YAML files to tell platform.sh what kind of application you're running and what services you need, but more on that later. Let's first see how the integration works. Once you have the add-on installed, you will be able to connect it to your repository. Thusly. We offer a free trial for all Bitbucket users. Just click on Create Free Project. Then, you will be able to choose the location of your cluster, and it's done. We are creating a new hosting environment for your project. We'll provision and configure not only the application server, but also databases, search engines, etc. You would find right there in the Bitbucket interface links to the relevant documentation on docs.platform.sh. Voila! You are in production. In a couple of seconds, everything would have been deployed. In platform.sh, the master is the live server. You can click on Go to platform.sh to manage the integration. Now time for magic. Let's create a new branch. This will be a development branch. In our toy example, the project we created had a MySQL, a Redis and a Solr instance linked to our application. Let's say we no longer need those and we just want a single MySQL instance in the cluster. We create a new branch for this change in our infrastructure and we call it services. Platform.sh will respect the tree structure of branches, so we'll first test this, later merge to development, and only once we are really happy, we'll merge to master in order to deploy to production. Here we see the file structure of our application. This is a Drupal site. We open the .platform.app.yaml file, and we are going to remove the unwanted relationships. Goodbye Solr and Redis. These are still going to be provisioned though. The application will simply no longer have access to them. Let's add a commit message and see what we've done. In the .platform directory, we have two other configuration files, routes.yaml controlling routing, and services.yaml that controls provisioning of backend services. We've removed Solr and Redis. They will no longer be provisioned after this. Let's add a commit message. With platform.sh, all infrastructure tasks go through Git. All are managed automatically. We create a nice pull request against the master branch and explain what we wanted to achieve. The pull request can be reviewed as usual, but oh, black magic. In the pull request itself, you will get a nice message from the platform pod informing you a new cluster has been provisioned. It is a precise clone of the production environment with all its data, and right there you have a link to go and test your new site. It's alive! Platform.sh not only automatically created for you a running site, but it created on the fly a new staging environment with its own URL on which you can test not only code changes, but also infrastructure changes. You can now manage your whole hosting infrastructure right inside your favorite Git hosting tool, Bitbucket. Every pull request gets on the fly a real live staging server. It works! Ship it! Learn more on platform.sh/bitbucket.